Now, the Roma Wine Company of Fresno, California presents...
Suspense. Tonight, Roma Wines bring you the distinguished actor, Mr. J. Carroll Nash, as star in Footfalls, a suspense play produced, edited, and directed by William Spear.
Suspense is presented for your enjoyment by Roma Wines. That's R-O-M-A, Roma Wines. Those excellent California wines that can add so much pleasantness to the way you live, to your happiness in entertaining guests, to your enjoyment of everyday meals. Yes, right now a glassful would be very pleasant, as Roma Wines bring you a remarkable tale of suspense.
And with a drama called Footfalls, and with the performance of Mr. J. Carroll Nash, Roma Wines hope indeed to keep you in suspense.
How are you feeling, Bose?
Good, Charlie. I feel good for a man who is going to die.
Oh, don't be silly. What do you want to talk that way for?
Oh, it's true. I know. But I don't feel bad. I ask you to come here only because I feel like talking a little while. You mind if I talk a little, Charlie?
Sure. You talk as much as you want.
Charlie Rugg. All these years a cop. But a good cop and a good friend.
You know I'm your friend, Bose.
Yes, I know it. All those years I knew it. All those years when I kept silent, waiting to kill a man. There are not many people now who still remember my Manuel. But you remember, even when he was a little boy. Yes, perhaps it was true. I was too fond, too easy on him after his mother died. But it was only because he was not strong. And he was a good boy. Always Manuel was a good boy. You were like the others, too, the way you thought of him. But you, I know it was because you were afraid he would bring sorrow to old Boaz. I remember the first time you were afraid when he was a little fellow. He had been standing beside me in the shop, watching me while I drove the nails into a pair of shoes.
Papa?
Yes, Manuel?
What are you doing?
What am I doing? Why, what I always do. I work. I mend shoes.
How do you?
What kind of questions do you ask me? How do I? You see, ever since you were a little boy, how I do. With my hands, my knife, my hammer, with the little nails.
But how can you work when you can't see?
Why do I have to see when I have my hands and my ears?
Papa? What's it like to be blind?
Why, it is not like anything. What I touch with my hands, what I hear with my ears, those things I see with my mind, as well as you do with your eyes. It is nothing to be blind. Ah, good morning, Mrs. Evans.
Good morning, Boaz. Hello, Manuel.
Hello. Papa, is it really true you can tell everybody by their footsteps?
Oh, of course. Didn't you see just then?
And you really can't see them at all? Not even a little bit?
Not even a little bit. To me, a footstep is as if you see a face or a voice. Each one is different. That is how I know people and remember them, even for many years.
All right. Tell me who's coming down the street now, but you mustn't look around.
Somebody is coming now? That is the easiest one of all. That is our policeman, Mr. Rock. Now, am I right?
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Charlie. You come for your shoes?
No, just passing by. But I'll pick them up if they're ready.
Not yet, Charlie. But you come back this afternoon, then they will be ready.
Papa, can I have a nickel?
Always a piece for the pocket, huh? Here's what they have. You take a nickel out, huh?
Thanks, Papa.
Here, you young scamp.
Let me go.
Well, what is it?
It wasn't a nickel he took. It was half a dollar.
Well, it was only a mistake. Manuel, you keep the half dollar nine and run along.
Thanks, Papa. Goodbye.
I didn't mean to butt in between you and your young one, Bose, but
I thought maybe you didn't...
And I did not know. Oh, I knew. But Manuel, he needs things now, and he is not like other boys. He's not too strong.
It's none of my business, but spare the rod, you know.
He is a good boy. My Manuel is always a good boy. So it was like that through the years. A quiet life, my work, my shop, my house behind the shop. A quiet life until that day he came. My Manuel, he was a big boy now, almost a man. Still, he was not strong. I remember that day. It was evening, and Manuel had just come into the shop. I knew what he wanted.
Hello, Pop.
Hello, Manuel. Well, you have a good day today?
Sure. Pretty good.
So, what were you doing today, huh?
Oh, walking around and thinking.
Thinking. Thinking about what?
Just about people and things.
They pay much for that kind of work, Manuel?
You want me to get a job, Pop?
No, Manuel. You do that when you want to. To work is good, but to think is good, too.
Ah, you're a swell guy, Pop.
But now, maybe a piece for the pocket?
Well...
$5? $10, maybe?
If it's all right.
Sure, it's all right. Here you are. A stranger coming down our street. You hear?
Not the way you do, Pop.
He's stopping at our door, I think.
Well, I think I'll be going, Pop.
Yes, Manuel. Good night.
Good night, Pop.
Mr. Negro? Mr.
Yes.
Boaz Negro?
Yes.
I'm a stranger in town, Mr. Negro, and...
Yes, I know.
What was that you said?
Oh, nothing. I was merely thinking out loud. Please continue, Mr.
Wood. Campbell Wood.
Mr. Wood. Campbell Wood.
Well, as I was saying, I'm a stranger in town, and I was told down at the depot that you had a room to rent.
Well, as a matter of fact, I have.
Well, I'm just starting at a new job in the bank, and I can't afford to pay too much, but...
Well, I always like to help a young fellow get a start in life. How would $5 a week suit you, Mr. Wood? That is, if you like the room.
Well, that'd be just fine, Mr. Negro. Now, if I could see the room...
So you are making your start in life, eh, Mr. Wood?
Well, I hope so, Mr. Negro.
You know, I can tell something about you, Mr. Wood, by your voice. But even more, by your footsteps.
By my footsteps?
That is a sort of specialty of mine. Yes, I think you will, as they say, go places, Mr. Wood.
Well, I'll certainly try.
Oh, yes, you will, Mr. Wood. Very definitely, you will go places. Yes, and I was right. He did go places, maybe even a little too fast. And there was talk. That fine young Mr. Wood who lived with old Boaz Negro, they said. What a contrast to that son, that Manuel who did nothing. Then that night when he came home so late. Ah, good evening, Mr. Wood. You are out rather late.
Yes, I had to attend a special Board of Trade meeting and... You're up rather late tonight.
Yes, I had to attend to my special shoes.
Mr. Boaz, I'd like to speak to you.
Do you have to have my permission?
Well, this affair is none of my business.
Go on.
Well, darn it, I hate to see a hard-working man like yourself support a lazy son.
Oh.
Why doesn't he get himself a job?
You know, my Manuel is not too strong.
Well, that's what I've heard you tell your friends, but he doesn't appear undernourished to me.
Really, Mr. Wood, my Manuel is not too strong.
Oh, couldn't he learn your trade, then?
Shoemaking? Well, that may be good enough for a blind man, but for Manuel...
Well, I'm getting a bit tired. Guess I'll be going upstairs.
I'll see you later. Darn it, I'm getting as careless as a newborn baby. No... Let me see. Yeah. There's that. Yeah. Ah. Am I glad it's all here? I'm responsible, you know.
Responsible? For what?
Why, for the gold I have in this sack. It's government money for the breakwater project.
Indeed, but why you
I know what you're thinking, Mr. Negro, but I'm keeping the money for the bank until tomorrow morning. You see, too many people in town know that we received the funds, and I don't trust the old safe we have down at the bank.
Very, very clever, Mr. Wood. So, you take the money home with you for safekeeping, and nobody is the wiser. Very clever.
Yes, I rather think so myself. And I'm glad I dropped the sack in front of you, Mr. Negro, because, well, I know I can trust you as far as, well, as far as I can trust myself.
That is a very fine compliment for an old cobbler, Mr. Wood.
Well, I'm going upstairs now. Remember, I have your word.
Yes, you have my word.
What's that?
Oh, a mouse, I suppose. I'll have to set a trap.
Is Manuel home?
No, Mr. Wood, he's not here. Good night. That was the first time I was frightened. That was the first time I ever thought of such a thing. Manuel was home, and he had heard everything, I thought. Manuel has heard the tinkle of gold. The tinkle of gold. Manuel.
Yes, Pop?
Did you hear, my boy?
Yes, I heard, Pop.
You won't say anything, huh?
Why should I?
You are a good boy, Manuel. Are you short of money? Perhaps $10?
Thanks, Pop, but I don't need it now.
Are you sure, Manuel? A fiver? Or a tenner?
Not now, Pop.
Some other time, huh?
Sure, Pop, sure. Some other time.
Some other time. My Manuel was a good boy. Yes, but I wished he did not know about the money. I tried to return to my work, but I could not. And suddenly I knew that I was listening. First I heard the footsteps there in the house behind the shop. The footsteps prowling here and there, halting, advancing again. Then others pacing back and forth, back and forth. A door opened. A voice.
Little casino? Gin rummy?
Sure, why not?
The steps again. The door closing and then silence. Oh, how I wished to know what that silence meant. And yet, though I wished to know stronger in me than that, I wished not to know. It was cold. I pulled on my old coat around me, still listening to the silence. A little later, I thought I heard a little sound like the rustling of the wind outside my shop, but I could not tell, and then perhaps I dozed there in my chair.
Smoke! Yeah, there is fire in my house! Fire! Help! Fire! Fire!
Was like a nightmare because I knew. Even as they poked and searched through the ashes of my house, I knew.
Hey, look here.
A body. A man's body.
Yeah, what's left of it?
Oh, a dreadful accident.
It wasn't an accident.
Yeah, why not? A guy can fall asleep with his clothes on.
But this guy's got his skull smashed in, and that makes it murder.
Murder.
Suspense, Roma Wines are bringing you a star, Mr. J. Carroll Nash, whom you have heard in the first act of Footfalls by Wilbur Daniel Steele, which is Roma Wines' presentation tonight of Suspense. And now, Roma Wines bring back to our Hollywood soundstage J. Carroll Nash, who, in the character of Boaz Negro, the blind cobbler, continues a narrative well calculated to keep you in suspense.
It is very kind of you to listen, Charlie. I feel suddenly so old. I feel that it is right for me to tell about it because sometime tonight I am going to go. Oh, but that nightmare day when the body was found in the ashes of my house, when I was forced, with my heart breaking, to agree with you that a dreadful crime had been committed. You remember, Charlie. You came to me here and...
Listen, Bose. We've identified the body every way there is. The clothes, the cufflinks, the watch they gave him at the bank. You know that. And the money's gone.
Yes.
All right, then. For the 100th time, where is Manuel? Where is Manuel?
And for the 100th time, I don't know.
Come on, Bose. Quit stalling. Where is he?
I am not stalling. I do not know, I tell you.
All right. When did you see him last?
After supper. He was in the shop.
You knew about the government money, Bose?
Yes.
Manuel. He knew, too? Manuel knew?
Yes.
I see. Just as I thought.
You must not think those things about my Manuel, Chief. He is a good boy.
What happened after you saw Manuel?
Nothing. He went in to sleep, and I stay in the shop and work.
I see. Did you hear anything, Bose?
Yes, I heard the men moving about.
What men?
Mr. Wood upstairs, my son down here.
Ah, then Manuel wasn't asleep.
No, he wasn't asleep.
Go on.
A while later, the noises stopped, and then...
We must know everything, Bose.
Well, a while later, Mr. Wood called down to my Manuel, and he asked him if he cared to come upstairs and play cards with him.
You heard him ask that?
Yes.
Are you sure it wasn't Manuel who asked Mr.
Wood? It is I who said, I do not lie to you.
All right. Did Manuel go up to Mr. Wood's room?
Yes, he went up.
I see. Now, did you hear anything else after that?
No, nothing.
Nothing, huh? Well?
There is something else. Sometimes during the night, I thought I heard something, footfalls perhaps, stealing past my shop.
I see. And you wouldn't swear in court that you did hear them?
No, not in court or here in my shop. I cannot swear to something I am not sure of.
Bose, you're a good man. And we don't want to cause any trouble, but you understand. A man has been murdered, government funds missing, and your son is gone. What else can we think? As far as I'm concerned, it's an open and shut case. I've issued a warrant for Manuel's arrest.
No, you cannot.
Yes. And if you know where he is, it'll go easier for him if you pass on that information.
I've told you all I wish to tell.
All right, be stubborn.
Stubborn. Do you wish me to dance a jig? I tell the truth and you do not believe me. What more can I do?
Gosh, put yourself in my place, Bose. This is serious business.
And will you change places with me? I have lost everything, my house, even my honor. My only son.
But I'm sorry.
Someday that murderer will return to the place of his crime, and when he does, I shall be waiting for him. Yes, then I will show you, for I shall be waiting for him. Questions I gave no answers. To threats I gave no heed. I scarcely heard them, for my ears were deaf to all sounds save one, the sound of footfalls. The footsteps of a murderer. Patiently as the weeks, the months, then the years moved by, I listened. For 3 years I listened, wondering only when they would come. For 3 years more, I wondered if they would come. Only the last 3 years was I troubled by the growing of a terrible doubt. Suppose the steps had come and gone and I had not heard. Suppose I were to make a mistake. Suppose my ears should fail me and I could not remember. Could not remember. From that first hour of doubt, every waking moment, yes, even in my dreams, I lived in a nightmare of echoing, jumbled footsteps. Footsteps slow, halting. Footsteps quick, running. Pounding, heavy footsteps. And those light as a cat's tread. More, faster, faster. Footsteps. It was the evening of the winter holidays, the Portuguese festival of Menin Jesu. Christ was born again in 100 mangers and 100 tiny altars. There was cake and wine and song, and in all the houses there were lights, even in my shop, the shop of Boaz Negro. A customer had just called for his shoes and gone out again. Now I was thinking of putting out those lights. I reached up to turn the switch, then stopped. Someone else had entered the shop. The newcomer stood by the closed door. I wondered why I had not heard the footsteps leading into the shop. Yes, what can I do for you?
Well, I don't know. Tell the truth.
You'll have to come nearer, please. I'm a little deaf.
All right.
Can you hear me now?
Fine. Just fine.
I have a pair of expensive boots with me, and they're in need of repair. Could you fix them?
I think so. If you would care to leave them with me.
Oh, darn it, I haven't got them with me right now. I just thought I'd look around a bit. And that, just, you know, look around your shop.
You're welcome. But I assure you there's not too much of interest in a poor cobbler's shop.
Oh, that may be true, but I really... The lights. Put on those lights. I can't see. Why'd you turn them off?
I can see much better in the dark.
You're crazy. You can't see at all.
How did you know?
Well, put on those lights.
Stay where you are. I can hear every move.
What are you going to do? Keep away from me. Don't touch me.
Murderer. Murderer. I've waited 9 years. I have lived for this day. Murderer. He died. Suddenly I realized this man I have killed has a beard, a full beard over his face, over his throat, where my fingers strangled him. Could I have been wrong? But no, the footsteps I was certain of. Then perhaps others would not know him for who he was if... Suddenly I knew what I must do. That his last cries had been heard, I knew, for I could hear the crowd gathering outside my locked door. Yet I set about my task carefully, as though he had been alive. With a sure, unhurried touch, I continued at my work, even as you battered at the door.
All right, stand back. All right, stand back, all of you. Stand back. Come on, Martin.
Yeah.
Lord only knows what we'll be finding here. Bose.
Dark as pitch.
Bose, where are you? Put on the lights, Martin.
Okay. I can't... Oh, here it is, Chief.
That's much better. Bose, what are you doing there on the floor? Bose, are you all right?
Hey, Chief, he's shaving someone.
Bose, what are you doing there?
It's all right, Charlie. I'm through. Now, tell me. Is it the murderer?
This guy on the floor is dead, Chief. Strangled.
Tell me, is it that murderer?
Manuel, Bose? You mean Manuel?
Not Manuel. I told you my Manuel was a good boy. But I ask you, is it that murderer?
Well, good Lord.
What's up, Chief?
Man on the floor. It's Campbell Wood, the bank fellow we thought was burned.
Burned? Him burned? No. It was my boy that was burned. That murderer killed my boy. He put his clothes on him and set my house on fire. I knew all the time.
Why didn't you tell us all this before?
And have you laugh in my face? Could I tell you I thought those footfalls moving along the side of the shop belonged to Mr. Wood? A blind man with crazy ideas, you would say. Could I stop and ask where he was going? If I were not blind, he would have killed me too. No. It was not my son who ran away. It was this murder all the time. But I told you he'd come back and I killed him. I showed you. Now, you can hang me for my crime. You remember, don't you, Charlie? And you did not even bother to arrest me. Perhaps you did not believe all boys had such strength in his old hands, huh?
He died of heart failure.
Did he? Well, so be it. But you believe now that old boys has no trouble with his ears, huh? Ah, yes. I hear everything. Even a voice close in my ear.
Pop. Hello, Pop. It's Manuel.
Yes. Yes, I hear. Oh, Manuel. How are things with you, Manuel?
Fine, Pop. Fine.
Do you need a little money? A fiver? Perhaps a tenner?
No, thanks, Pop. Not now.
Some other time?
Pop, I'm waiting for you, Pop.
Yes, I know you are waiting, and I am glad to come with you. My Manuel is a good boy.
And so closes Footfalls, in which Roma Wines have brought you J. Carroll Nash, a star of tonight's study in Suspense.
This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.